You're watching UNICEF television. These children's faces cannot be shown. And these young women's faces cannot be shown. Their identities must be protected because they are victims of trafficking, pornography, prostitution, rape, or abuse, all forms of sexual exploitation. It's not only their identities that need protection.
When clients came to the brothel, we tried to lock the doors or hide.
He called me in his room and asked me to scratch his back. He held me and lay me down on the bed. I began to shout. He had a knife beside him. He said that if I talked, he would kill me.
I met a man when I was 9.5 years old. He worked at a nightclub, and he took me with him, and that's how it started.
The sexual exploitation of children and adolescents is a global reality and is gaining a growing visibility.
It looks like she's 4 years old, and this looks like an 8-year-old child and a 4-year-old having sex.
Eliminating these horrific practices and protecting children and adolescents are major challenges for the international community.
It is happening that children are being used as sex toys, that children are being used as sex commodities.
This year, the Third World Congress Against the Sexual Exploitation of Children and Adolescents is being held in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. The aims of the Congress are to bring light to the ongoing problem of sexual exploitation, a problem that by its very nature keeps many of its victims in secrecy, ashamed and afraid. UNICEF supports special programs around the world. In Liberia, a safe house for abused young women. In Kyrgyzstan, a center for homeless and vulnerable children. In the Philippines, a peer education project. In Guatemala, protective services for children on the streets. As a key organizer of the Congress, UNICEF will join the international community to better protect children from sexual exploitation, reinforcing the basic right to protection that must be guaranteed for all children. This is Amy Bennett reporting for UNICEF Television. Unite for Children.